the dogs are.
Funny. I've never had that one before.
Yeah, well, we're just here for a drink.
You're not interested then?
No, and neither is he.
I'll tell you something. Women are the worst. 385.
How'd you mean?
Having a flutter. Horses, dogs, football. They come in here straight from the supermarket down the road, leave their shopping trolleys on the corner.
Get out.
Straight up. Fancy a bit.
No, we're just having the one, right?
You reckon? We'll go when I'm ready.
Jackie?
What?
These optics. The whiskey and the vodka are a bit low.
Dad, I'm up to my eyes.
What would I do without her, eh?
The trouble with fathers is you're stuck with them.
All the forms in there. Beats the betting shop. Ringside seat.
Hello, Jamie. Jamie Porter, a pony.
Oh, right. 8-1.
Yeah, Jamie Porter, eh? 225.
He don't give him monkeys, does he?
Yeah, what you call well overdue. Chris.
Gov.
John Bolton about?
Not at the moment, no.
This blag that he rags is going down.
He says he'll know for certain about it this morning.
What's the matter? Couldn't you sleep?
Hard night.
Hectic.
Come a cropper, did you?
A dog called Jamie Boy. Cost me more than 500 quid.
The heart bleeds. Now, this wages snatch on the Canley Industrial Estate?
It's today, like I said.
What time? You said you thought there were two men behind it.
Yeah, well, they'll be in this afternoon to watch the racing. I don't really know them, John. But they're 400 quid down. They promised to settle it by tonight.
I need the name of the firm, Vinny.
Come back at 2 o'clock. Have I ever let you down?
Dad.
About time. Where you been? You're going to have to get a move on if you're going to be back here before I open.
Be as quick as I can. You know what the checkout queues are like.
Oh, you know John. He's a mate.
Yeah. His feeder cup's here if he starts.
Come here, buster. We'll sort you out. Come to granddad. Yeah, you all right for tonight? I did say I needed you all this week. Jackie.
And I said, I can't. I'm not doing full time.
You got any kids, John?
No.
They're always this big.
Give it a rest, Dad.
You never stopped looking out for them, ever since her mother left here. It makes sense for you to move back in here.
I've told you, Dad, no.
Oh, her bloke's done a runner. He's in Spain.
Go on, tell everyone my business.
Nags you to death, does he? I'm on your side. 2 o'clock, all right, Vinny?
I'll have it.
Now, look, what I'm saying is it's harmless, right? A couple of quid on the dogs, a few bob on the horse.
But Vinnie Rogers hasn't got a licence.
He's gambling illegally, Reg.
We've got to move with the times.
Reg,
the law can be an ass, we know that.
But not as big an ass as you, Reg.
Vinnie, it's going to start.
Go on, Vinnie.
Yeah,
come on,
Vinnie. Right.
Keep it down, keep it down.
I'd say now, Sarge.
Yeah, I think you're right.
Well, it's gone too, sir. Any minute now, eh?
Yes, Reg. Sir?
Trail by 2 lengths from Bunny Lane.
Yes!
60 quid.
I pay on the way in.
What?
I pay on the way in, right?
All right, everybody. All right. This is a police raid. Everybody stay where you are. That includes you, please, sir.
What is this?
Oh, Mr. Rogers?
A raid? 2 o'clock in the afternoon.
Vinnie Rogers, sir. The landlord.
Inspector Monroe, Sun Hill. Can you turn the TV off, please?
We've seen him take bets from 1:30. Most of the customers are still here.
Yeah.
Sergeant Boyden, WPC Page.
And last night we saw him take at least 14 bets.
The betting slips are in a pot behind the bar.
I'm not laying. I run into a bookmaker.
Which bookmaker would this be? Stay where you are. Officers are coming round. They may want your names and addresses. Please cooperate. Matthew, point out the punters, will you?
Sir.
Excuse me. Mr. Rogers, you're contravening the Betting, Gaming and Lotteries Act. John? I'm afraid the bar's closed.
Number 11, Jackie Miller.
Was it you that called the station?
She won't answer us. She's screaming and crying. Things are being smashed.
There's a child in there.
We understood there was a disturbance.
It was a man. He came calling on her.
Did you see him?
He ran away. He slammed the door after him.
Husband, boyfriend?
Oh, he left months ago. Oh, that poor child.
Mrs. Miller? Mrs. Miller, this is the police. Can you open the door, please?
Can we come inside?
I'm all right. Honest.
I think we should go inside. Thanks.
Single mothers.
We take it in turns to look after that poor mite 3 evenings a week.
Yeah?
Madam works down the Alcott Arms.
Yeah, well, it's not a crime yet, is it?
Who did you let in?
Simon, my husband.
Your husband?
That's what I said.
Likes to use his fists, does he?
He wants to see more of Daniel.
Is there a court order out?
No.
So this is about access, is it? Jackie, you're shaking. Shall I hold Daniel?
I'm all right.
Do you want to pursue this?
Look, it won't happen again.
You're sure about that, are you?
Jemma.
Will you please go? It'll be all right. If it isn't, I'll...
You'll call us?
Yeah, I will.
You don't seem to realise what you've done. Vinnie Rogers is one of my best contacts. He was giving me details of a wages snatch on the Canley estate today.
Not my problem.
He's clammed up on me.
I checked with the DIU. There's nothing about the Elkhart Arms being a source of information.
You think I'm sticking his name on a computer screen for the world and his wife to know about?
Yeah, but we're not the world and his wife.
You could have fooled me. The place was crawling with uniform. Who knew about your raid?
Those who needed to.
I'm talking to you.
I suggest you cool off, mate.
Cool off? Yeah, because it's just another cock-up, isn't it? I suppose I should be used to uniform incompetence by now.
Right! That's enough!
The point is, Derek, nobody downstairs had the courtesy to inform us that a raid was being planned.
It's not a question of courtesy, Jack. It's procedure.
Don't give me that.
Look, if John Bolton's got egg on his face, he should pause and reflect.
I'm not worried about John Bolton's feelings. Your raid on the Elkhart Arms cost us information on a blag going down today. And it's not the first time the uniform have done this.
Matthew Boyden was following up a complaint from a local betting office. If he knew that CID was cultivating the licensee, he may have held fire.
Why aren't we told when you plan to turn somebody over?
You know the time and trouble that goes into undercover work.
Hang on a minute, was this Operation Log?
Come on.
Matthew Boyden was on surveillance, right? More than once. Was this Log with the DIU?
Of course not. One wrong word would scupper the whole thing.
What do you mean? One wrong word from us? We'd mess it up.
I didn't say that, did I?
So what are you saying then? CID can't be trusted?
Well, let's see. Suppose it wasn't in your interest to have this licensee turned over.
You what?
Suppose you wanted to warn him.
Now that's out of order.
Is it? This Vinnie Rogers at the Elkhart Arms was a good contact of John Bolton's. A you scratch my back, I'll scratch yours kind of contact.
Now wait a minute.
John Bolton must have known he was into illegal gambling. Did he tell us? Did he put anything on the computer? It works both ways, Jack. We all want results.
Right, this problem's going to get sorted right now.
What you don't do is start shouting the odds at one of my sergeants.
I don't think I was talking out of turn, sir. I've got good grounds.
If so, you come to see me. Is that clear?
All right. If there's a blag on the Canley estate today, and we all end up in the middle of a shooting match, I'll know I could have stopped it. I hope that's clear, sir.
Jack, you admit that none of John Bolton's information was fed to the DIU. What are uniforms supposed to have, a crystal ball? You know the guidelines. Information doesn't belong to one single officer or one single department.
CID is only as good as the information it's got, and I won't have it bandied around the neck. Now, what I suggest...
Yeah, come in.
Sorry, am I interrupting?
No, it's all right, Derek. We weren't cooking up anything behind your back.
This about getting our wires crossed over the Elkhart Arms?
Yes, it is. I was explaining to Jack I'm not having a culture of secrecy here at Sun Hill. That goes for you as well.
Well, I think there may be a way out of our immediate problem, sir. We reassure John Bolton's licensee contact that we'll take a lenient view of his illegal gambling. Customs won't be informed, and we'll have a word with his area manager so he keeps his job. That should mend fences.
Yeah, sounds like a good idea, Jack.
Yeah, well, I'm more interested in establishing a basis for a permanent arrangement.
I'm rather snowed under at the moment, Jack. We'll have to talk about it another time. But yes, mending fences sounds like a good idea. We need to do something here at Sun Hill as well. I know how divisive these things can be. So put the word about, will you? Otherwise, I'll start imposing solutions that neither of you will like.
Tell you, George, it was first-class entertainment, and all free.
Courtesy of Her Majesty's Metropolitan Police Service.
Any chance of doing any work today?
Just on my way, Sarge.
The word is, we're putting it down to experience. Got it?
Got it, Sarge.
What are you doing in?
We're just brought in the D&D. Jamila's sorting it. It's all happening at the Elkhart Arms, then.
Why?
Well, we had a shout about an hour ago. A girl called Jackie Miller. Works in a pub, apparently.
Jackie?
Yeah, she's 22, 23, fairish hair, good looker.
Yeah, the licensee's daughter. What's her problem?
Yeah, it looks like she's got trouble. Man got into her house, assaulted her, and then smashed the place up. Now, she said it was her husband, but the neighbours reckon the husband's not around. It just sounded a bit odd, that's all. But there's nothing on either of them here.
Vinny. Look, about the raid, I've sorted it. You're going to be okay. I'm sorry, mate.
You weren't looking after me, John.
Look, you're off the hook. The chief inspector's promised, just no more betting, right?
You should have squared it a long time ago.
Oh, come on, what is this?
I'm sorry.
Hang on. Tell me what you know about this blag.
I got it wrong. There's no job going down today.
These two men, did they come in at lunchtime?
Didn't show.
Then how do you know the blag's off?
Let's just call it quits, John.
I got you a deal.
Look, I'm busy, I'm sorry. If there was anything, I'd have told you.
Any luck with Vinny?
Like you said, not your problem.
Yeah, well, for what it's worth, there's been an incident involving Jackie Miller, Vinny's daughter, works at the pub.
What sort of incident?
Says her husband smashed the place up, we sorted her.
Her husband's in Spain.
Well, then she's telling porkies, isn't she?
Our uniform got it wrong.
Take it or leave it. Only the officer dealing thinks there's more to it. He even came in to check their names. George Garfield, if it's not beneath you.
Jackie Miller. I'm DC Carver. It's about your visitor. It won't take long.
I've told you like everything.
Mrs. Miller, please.
I'm on my way out.
Well, I think you've already met DS Bolton.
Hello, Jackie.
Excuse me. Are you the police?
Yeah.
Are you going to sort her out?
Well, how do you mean?
That child, for a start. She's off to her afternoon job. Where's she going to dump him now?
Your dad's going to be okay. I've fixed it for him.
I'll bet you have. Excuse me.
Will you stop a minute?
There's nothing to stop for.
Have you got a problem?
No problem.
Who was the man who called on you today?
You've been told who it was.
Does your dad know about it?
What are you going to do? Run round and tell him? Give him a bit more grief.
She's off to work. Not the Elcott Arms. She's got a part-time job on the Candy Estate.
Where did that come from?
The usual. How's your neighbour?
Well, well. Elcott Street.
She must be popping in on Daddy. Has Vinny got any form?
No. His dad was a bookmaker, so Vinny said it was either that or become a publican.
Well, he seems to have managed to combine both.
Oh, don't you start. Aye, aye.
Whatever our problem is, I think Daddy's up to speed with it.
Keep tabs on the gym. I'm gonna find out what the hell's going on. Lock the top, please, mate. Plenty of lemonade. It's thirsty work chasing your daughter.
Why are you on her back?
She's got trouble. Any idea why?
Well, it's personal. Her other half.
You told me he was in Spain.
He's back.
I don't think so, Vinny. Who dropped in on her today? I see, maybe you're both being lent on. The two men you were putting a finger on, Vinny, who are they?
You're too late, they moved on.
Jackie should be arriving at her part-time job roundabout now, on the Canley Industrial Estate. If a robbery goes down there today, and I find out either of you knew anything about it, I am personally going to make sure Uniform throw the book at you, kick you out of this pub, and stop you ever getting another one. Bolton. Jim!
Sarge, she stopped at a place called Goldman Electrics in Malham Street.
Great, well I want you to get in there, Jim, and ask the boss if he's having the firm's wages collected today. I'm on my way. You got anything to say to me, Vinny?
Your wages clerk goes to the bank every week.
He always takes a different route.
So he picks up the firm's wages and then he comes back here.
Always at a different time.
And what about today?
What is this?
Mr. Hewitt, are the firm's wages being picked up today?
Yes.
At what time?
4 o'clock.
He should be on his way back now.
Any more details?
You're looking for a blue Rover 820E. We think it's been ambushed. The driver's badly hurt. Suspects are believed to be armed. ARV on way.
Junction of Godwick Road and what? Repeat location, please.
Sierra 1, believed to be the junction of Godwick Road and Plessy Street.
Sierra Oscar from 360, urgent message.
Go ahead, Steve.
Ambulance, please. Junction of Godwick Road and Plessy Street. All right, can you hear me?
Right, did anybody see anything?
No.
Anybody?
2 men in a car. They came from nowhere, cut in, forced him to crash.
Did you get the registration?
They had these bats, baseball bats. They took a briefcase.
Yeah. Well, just hang on a minute.
Ah, Mr. Hewitt, Sarge, the manager. The firm's wages have been picked up this afternoon. £10,000. The wages clerk is alone. He's driving a Blue Rover H20E.
It's too late, Jim. We've just had news of a robbery come through. Will you check the details for me? Right, your vehicle was a Blue Rover registration J910CUW. Who knew when the money was being picked up?
Nobody. Sheila, who does the accounts.
What about Jackie Miller?
She works here part-time, helps out in the office.
Does that include accounts? I'd like a word with her.
Jackie.
Now, please.
Sheila, send Jackie in, will you?
How long's she been working for you? A
couple of months.
She's got a child.
We've a crash.
So how come you're still in the Stone Age with your wages?
You see, the last time we were picking up cash, we're going over the bank payments next week.
I'd like a word with Jackie alone, please, Mr. Hewitt.
Yes, yes.
Okay, thanks. They use baseball bats. Hello again, Jackie. Did you know the firm's wages were being picked up at 4 o'clock in cash today?
What's happened?
I'm told you would know. Did you tell anyone?
No.
What about your dad?
No.
So it was just you and the 2 men, was it? Customers in your pub? How is the wages clerk then, Jim?
Severe head injuries. It's touch and go.
About these 2 men, Jackie?
I don't know anything.
Right. Yeah, thanks.
I know my daughter's been arrested. Where is she now? Is she still here?
I'm sorry, I don't know the details. All I know is DS Bolton's on his way through.
John, what's happened? Where's Jackie?
In here.
Is she all right? Well, is she all right?
Depends on what you mean by all right. If you mean is she safe, yes. If you mean is she up to her armpits in a 10,000 quid robbery, it went off all right. Goldman Electric's on the estate. Wages clerk in intensive care. Your daughter banged up in a cell. Nice one. But you knew all about that, of course.
I don't know anything.
How long are you going to keep this up for?
What she said.
Very little.
And you expect me to drop her in it?
She's mixing with lowlife from your pub. You know it, I know it. Face it, Vinny. She's well and truly nicked.
She should have come to live with me when her mother left.
She met these jokers working in your pub. Let go. It's too late. You can't go on protecting her. She's not your little girl anymore.
I didn't know Jackie was involved. She told me this morning after she saw you in the pub.
You used the raid as an excuse to mess me about.
I had to back off.
The 2 men you were tipping me off about. I want their names. Now.
Pete and Foster.
These punters at your pub?
One's a Geordie. The other one's Black from Liverpool.
Is that it?
Well, one of them, Peter, called on her at lunchtime. He'd come in the pub to meet with Foster. Saw the raid going on, thought she'd double-crossed him. Then he went round Jackie's house, smashed it all up. Said he'd hurt the boy if she tried to grass him up.
I want a statement, Vinny. I want descriptions. I want everything you've got.
So our input was useful then, Sarge?
Jackie Miller certainly was.
But CID, Mr. Blake.
Too slow off the mark. So they'd be stamping their little feet and bursting with the tears all over us.
Matthew, can I have a word, please? You know your raid on the Elkhart Arms? You'd have a list of the punters.
We took names.
And addresses.
And addresses?
Are they all kosher?
Come again?
Well, they'd want to give you false names, wouldn't they?
They would.
But they didn't.
You think we all fell off a Christmas tree? We get ID.
Could you check if there's a Foster among them?
Foster. Any first name?
That is his first name.
Anything else?
IC3, he's about 5'10", Liverpool accent. He's got a scar on his neck just here.
Rings a bell?
Thanks.
10 minutes.
Well, I'm waiting to interview a suspect now.
Yeah, well, my beans on toast is getting cold. It's not going to become a habit, is it? Uniform sorting you out.
The first man's called Foster Dixon, from Liverpool. He's got a mate called Pete Ford.
He's the one who knocked on your door today.
Who told you that? Dad?
How long did you expect your dad to go on lying for you? How did you get mixed up with these men?
They came in Tibet, 20s and 50s. They said there's not many places left where you see money like that changing hands. It's all check cards now. I said I knew one. I still got paid in notes at Golden Electrics.
They must have thought it was their birthday.
They said it would be simple. Nobody would get hurt. We'd split the money three ways.
You went along with it?
I'm on my own. It's just me and Daniel. You don't know how hard it is.
Your dad wants to give you a job.
Oh, tied to his apron strings. Yeah, he'd let that up. Me living in, working seven nights a week, chatting up all the punters. The barmaid, they all want to screw. That's no life. Why do you think Mum walked out? I'm not running back to him.
What did friends Foster and Pete tell you to do?
I didn't want to do it, not when it came down to it.
All right, you got cold feet. What did you have to do?
Ring Foster when I got to work. Tell him where and when the money was being picked up.
And that's what you did? Out loud for the tape, please.
Yes.
Do you know where these men live? Do you know where we could find them? You've got over $3,000 coming to you. How are you going to get it?
I'm meeting Foster later.
You what?
He used to take me home from the pub. He'd wait outside so Dad wouldn't find out. I'm seeing him.
What's he doing? Putting her through the ringer?
Denny, I suggest you go back to the pub and you keep your nose clean.
Don't soft soap me. I want to see her.
She's helping us with our inquiries.
You're bullying her, aren't you? She was forced into it.
Not quite, Vinny. She's going to lead us to one of the men. Apparently, your little girl was about to shack up with one of them. Oh, you didn't twig it? Or you just didn't want to face up to it?
Is this them?
Jackie?
Yeah.
DC Carver from DS Bolton, they've arrived.
You ready, Sarge?
DS Beach from DS Bolton, go, go, go!
Police! Stay where you are!
Foster Dixon!
I'm DS Bolton
on Sunhill!
Behave yourself!
I'm arresting you for robbery!
You do not have to say anything!
Get up!
But it may harm your defence if you do not mention when questions
are being
made.
Give me
a line of court! Anything you do say may be given in evidence!
Get him in a van!
Get him!
Oh, John, I gather we rescued something from the day.
Yes, sir, we've cracked it. We're interviewing in half an hour.
Oh, is Matthew now?
Probably not, sir.
Apparently, we've sorted out the robbery on the Canley estate.
Really?
Good old-fashioned result, eh, John?
Wonderful.
I gather you had some input as well.
We do our best, sir.
Good. Common sense is the watchword, cooperation the key. Don't want lots of hard and fast rules, do we? Lots of red tape?
No, sir.
Matthew?
Absolutely, sir.
Good. Well, I think we understand each other.